In the previous lecture on the harmonic oscillator, let me review what we did earlier. We considered the potential half kx square, which is equal to this. We tried to solve the Schrödinger wave equation based on this potential with the help of algebraic method, and we derived two operators, the raising operator and the lowering operator, in this form. While treating the operator, we came across the commutation relation. So for any two operators, when we want to find out whether the order of their measurement will disturb the measurement, for when one operator is operated earlier and the other the second, whether this thing will be equal to zero or non-zero. So we will have to see whether this thing is equal to zero. If this is equal to zero, it means the two operators are commuting with each other and the order of their measurement is not giving different measurement. While if this thing is non-zero, then it means they are the non-commuting operators. During our derivation, we came across with the position and momentum operator, and we came to know that they are non-commuting operators and this thing is non-zero. So we did the commutation relation for a minus and a plus as well, and it came out to be 1. We wrote the Hamiltonian in this form, h bar omega, in terms of the raising and lowering operators. Then with the help of the lowering operator a minus, we derived the ground state wave function of the harmonic oscillator, which is equal to this. And by applying the relation that when raising operator is operated on the ground state wave function, we will have psi 1 of x, and we normalized this wave function, this state, and the constant of normalization came out to be this. In addition to this constant of normalization in the ground state, we got this factor as well. Similarly, we derived the second excited state wave function as well, which was equal to this. We came to know that the first is the even function, while the second was the odd function and then the even function. So the states of the harmonic oscillator were alternatively even and odd, even, odd. And we wrote the generalized wave function, means the nth state wave function is an a plus to the power n psi naught of x with energy equal to this. Now, every time we find a state, for example, we find psi 3, we will have to normalize, or we will have to find out this constant of normalization, which is rather a difficult job to do this thing. So we can find this normalization constant algebraically by doing some algebra, and we will start this lecture with this, that how to find the normalization constant algebraically. So we will have to address this question, and let's start with this. We know about one thing, that if I take psi n, means being the ground state of wave function, any psi n, any state from minus infinity to plus infinity, and this psi n mod square dx is equal to 1. It's a normalized wave function, normalized state. So what about if I go beyond this state? For example, what will be minus infinity to plus infinity in any other state, psi n plus 1 mod square dx, what this will be equal to? So in order to see this thing, we know that psi n of x is equal, psi n was equal to a n a plus n and psi naught. So we will have to apply a plus on the ground state wave function, and it will cause this constant to be find as well. So to do this thing, let's say I write that when a plus operates on psi n, then let's say it gives me any constant, and then psi n plus 1. So from this one I can write that any psi n plus 1 will be equal to some constant, let's say any constant, and then a plus on psi n. Now this constant is, let's say I write this one is c plus, and then a plus psi n. Now in the same, I can write minus. So the minus I will just write with another color. So minus 1, here it will be another constant, and this one, and here I write minus with this one. So c plus is one constant, c minus is another constant. So we will have to go on with this, that when this will be psi n minus 1, means it is lowered in state, then this one will become a minus, and I will write here a minus. So this one, when it is raised from psi n to psi n plus 1, it is a plus operator. When it is lowered, it is psi n minus 1, and it will be the minus operator, a minus, the lowering operator. And alternatively, it will change the constants as well. So let me write now normalize this wave function. So to normalize this wave function, the normalization condition is from minus infinity to plus infinity. And this will be psi n plus minus 1 mod square dx, and this will be equal to 1. So we will have to normalize this wave function now, and this implies that put this value here, psi n plus minus 1 value here, so we will get c plus minus, and this c plus minus will be squared as well. So square this one, c squared plus minus, and then we will have integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, and put this value a plus minus psi n mod square and dx, and this value is equal to 1. Now we will have to put it in another way, and the other way is that this is equal to c square plus minus, and from minus infinity to plus infinity, and this one I can write as a plus minus psi n conjugate, the steric of this one, into a plus minus psi n and dx. And now I will have to do one calculation, and for that, let's say we are having two functions, and two functions, one is f of x and another is g of x. And these two functions are such that these two functions are going to zero when x goes to plus minus infinity. So these functions are just like my wave functions, because my wave function is also going to zero when x goes to plus minus infinity. And I do its integration, and it is like f conjugate, and I apply a plus minus on this g and dx. Now I know that what are the values of a plus and a minus from here, that a plus a minus is actually equal to minus ip m omega x. So I can write here that a plus minus is, this is minus ip, so p is minus I h bar, minus minus will become plus, and I will become square, so again it will become minus, so 2m h bar omega and minus h bar d over dx plus m omega x. Similarly, here is minus and here will become plus. So we will have to use here d by dx. I will not do for the other one because it will also come out to be the same. But let's do one component of this one. Then it will be from minus infinity to plus infinity, and f conjugate, and when I will put, forget about the constant, but the minus h bar and d by dx. So when I will write, forget about the h bar as well, and this will be dg over dx and some other terms as well. So let's write those other terms here and dx. When I will do integration by parts, then it will be, I'm just looking to the two terms, first function into integration of the second function, so it will become gn from minus infinity to plus infinity, minus whole integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, derivative of the first function, d over dx of this one, into integration of the second function, which will become g and dx. Now I know one thing, that the g is going to 0 at minus plus infinity. So this term will become 0 minus integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, and here I see that d by dx is having no iota involved, so writing this inside the conjugate will not affect our calculation, and g of dx. So look here and here, means this is having some other terms involved here, so by utilizing that I can write that this one will be equal to integral from minus infinity to plus infinity. When I want to switch this one here, then minus sign will be additional, and when I multiply minus sign with this, then it will change. So minus will become plus and plus will become minus. So what it will be like this, that a minus plus and this f and whole conjugate g of x and dx. So from here we can now write that if I want to move this one, this a minus a plus minus over here, then it will change the sign. So I can write here that c square plus minus is from minus infinity to plus infinity, and I can move this one here, so it will become a minus a plus and a plus minus psi n, and this will be now conjugate, and I will write this one is psi n dx. Now I know from my this calculation that from here a plus minus a minus plus plus minus half psi equals e psi. So I can write that this thing is equal the a minus a plus minus, I can write in the form of Hamiltonian, is this is c square plus minus from minus infinity to plus infinity, and here I can write for this h over h bar omega plus half plus minus half, and then I will write psi n, and it will be whole conjugate psi n